Hey everyone, my name is Heroicus, and welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm. This I've not played yet. I have an idea of a few things that are gonna happen in the story, because I've already played Life is Strange, the first game, but this whole game is a prequel to that game. So, we're gonna start with the bonus episode, because this chronologically comes first. And then we'll get to the other episodes. Toy Story just took a dark turn.
Ready, I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet oh dear.
A hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Oh god, this is gonna be bad. Why aren't you doing this outside? You're gonna light a fire or something. Oh no.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen. That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome? That's like asking why are puppies cute? Some things just are. I'm not sure your mom would see it that way. When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I'd better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Okay.
Feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now. In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her? I better help Chloe with her cleaning.
Damn, that camera's a lot smoother in this game. Alright, look.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Good job. Alright, let me see. I need to change the setting on that. Come on, how do I... Oh, okay. Let's try two bars. Alright, that's a little better.
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever. But neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
I can't even... The Adventurous Adventures of Supermax and Dr. Chloe and... Kloenstein? Our crime fighting has really soared since you created those rocket boosters. Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Cloenstein? What the hell's even... Yeah, what is happening in this last one? Whatever.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course.
Who's Bongo? Is Bongo the bear?
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month. How sick was that show? The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts.
All right. Back to the junk mines.
Okay.
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
Sounds like something we can put in the trash.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Chloe, we haven't played this game in years. And it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max. But you can't erase your shame that easily.
I had a feeling she was gonna do that.
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, O almighty Chloe Bear.
Okay, what else do we got?
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather.
What's this?
Talk about embarrassing.
I feel like she's going to stop me from throwing this out as well.
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
She's just gonna make me put everything back, isn't she? Okay. Why can't I throw out the doll head? Because that's literally trash.
Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies. That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care if you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think it deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
I want to look around a little bit.
Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, kind of cool.
And that is how Max invented the selfie.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
The parents of Chloe Price, dear parents, congratulations, your child Chloe Price has been accepted for September 2008 admission to Blackwell Academy. We have offered places to approximately 100 students out of 1,200 applicants. Your child excelled in all criteria for admission. An open house for admitted students and parents will be held on March 26th. April 2nd is the deadline to inform us of your intentions regarding admission. Your admission reply form is included. For those who require financial aid, please contact Blackwell's Office of Financial Assistance. We look forward to welcoming you and Chloe to the Blackwell Academy family. Sincerely, Marco S. Gonzalez, Director of Admissions.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know. I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks, I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Okay. Oh wait, is there more to look at over here? Drawer. Oh dear.
I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
Let's try one more thing.
This seems like a good candidate. Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You haven't touched these since the fifth grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of.
At least you didn't saw me in half.
How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything? A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Alright, I officially give up on that. Okay.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
This room is far from clean.
It would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Let's get it over with.
Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. I don't know how
Holy
to...
shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Pirate related?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Our powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Treasure ye see. My eyes spot two fair pirate wenches. Oh, lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
Find the treasure of Price Isle. You will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
That was dorky.
So dorky. What were we thinking? I thought we were lovable. Okay, okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Alright. The Bane of Arcadia. Oh god. Ah, there's a cat. Pirate rules. No bathing. No boys on the ship. No sharing pirate secrets. Always share plunder. Always bury treasure. Always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Captain's log. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. Our just buried treasure has come under attack again. The evil commander Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wanted to steal it from us. We are doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it, because our enemies want our treasure so bad. We must make sure the map is only readable to us, Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver, to more plunder and riches.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Well, that's not good.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. Where could it be?
No, I don't want to look at the book. I want to look at the sketchbook.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year. I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. I wonder if I could still get to the end.
Let's have a look. Max and Chloe's sewer adventure. You are Max and Chloe, the best friends of students in school. You sit in class until suddenly a cute squirrel arrives at the window. It is so cute. Do you want to pet it? Pet the squirrel. Go to page 8. Don't pet the squirrel. Page 3. Well, I'll pet the squirrel. You go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course, why wouldn't you? It's a cute squirrel and you want to pet it. Hey, Mr. Squirrel, you say. Ah, stop biting me, you say next, because the squirrel is now biting your hand. But it's too late. You have rabies. Miss Anders has to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her very sad. Guess you shouldn't have pet the squirrel. Alright. Let's not pet the squirrel. Page 3. Why don't you like squirrels? They're so cute and nice. You must be very mean. Well, I don't want to fucking die. Squirrel seems annoyed that you ignored her. She runs in and steals the book report off of your desk, then runs back outside. That squirrel stole my book report, you tell the teacher. Uh-huh, whatever you say, Miss Anders responds, clearly not believing me. You, what do you do? Stay in class? You decide to not chase the squirrel when the time comes to present your book report. You tell Miss Anders that the squirrel stole it and ran away. She doesn't believe you. Remember, I told you she doesn't believe you. Why didn't you listen? You should pay more attention. Anyway, Miss Anders reports you to the principal, and soon you are kicked out of school for being a bad student. Without school, you can't ever get a job or make money. Now you live in a shack without TV and do drugs, so you will be dead. Guess you should have paid attention. Alright. Alright. 3, 4. As soon as Miss Anders turns around, you run out the window and chase the squirrel. That is a very bad thing to do, and you hope you don't get in trouble later, but you probably will. Outside, you look around, but you can't find the squirrel. Is she gone? Oh, there she is. She's standing up next to a sewer hole. You run up to her, but she gets scared and jumps down. Oh boy, do you really want to go down there? Guess we're going to have to. You are very brave. You leap down into the sewer. Thankfully, there is a pile of trash, banana peels, and dirty diapers to land on. I immediately regret this decision. You hear a squirrely sound in the distance, so you run to follow it. There are many twists and turns. Eventually, you come to a fork in the road. But now's not the time for eating, so you put the fork back down and consider the two paths in front of you. On the ground, you see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of chewed up paper to the right. Which way do you go? Based on the number of pages, I'm gonna take 7. Smart choice. You go to the right, following the path of chewed papers. After a bit of walking, you end up in a dark corner. Suddenly, the floor falls away. You find yourself swimming in some sort of warm liquid, almost like a big puddle, except why does this liquid taste like acorns? A bright light comes on. It turns out you're not in a puddle. You're in a big bowl of acorn soup, and all around you are squirrels holding spoons and wearing tiny little aprons. They look so cute, and the soup keeps getting hotter. I guess you weren't too smart after all. At least you'll be delicious. Alright, go back to that. Page 9. You picked right. I mean left, which was right. It's confusing. In the distance, you see the squirrel, but he's not moving. In fact, he's dead. Who would kill a poor squirrel? Suddenly, the ground begins to shake. Around the corner, a giant rat appears. It's the biggest rat you've ever seen. The biggest anything you've ever seen. It's the Rat King. The Rat King is wearing a crown and standing on a throne of all. You're missing homework, including your book report. What do you do? I'm gonna have to run towards it, I'm assuming. Your dad always tells you to run toward your problems, not away from them. Unfortunately, you picked a really bad time to start listening to him. You run straight towards the Rat King. At first he seems surprised, and you try to punch him in his face, but you forgot about his long, hairy, gross tail. It wraps you up like a boa constrictor and drops you into his mouth, swallowing you with one gulp. Now you get to see what the inside of a rat looks like. This would make a great science report. Too bad you won't be alive to tell anyone. Alright, I gotta go back. Okay, page 7. Wait. Page 9. Page 5. You run away like a scaredy cat. I don't blame you. That thing is gross. As you run, you almost trip on a small, shiny object. Pick it up. It's a lighter. Your mom never lets you play with these, but she's not here right now, is she? Now is your chance to kill the Rat King and protect all the students' homework once and for all. This is your chance to be a hero. Do you do it? Just kidding. You don't get a choice. You may get to choose some things, but I'm still the author here. You have to attack the Rat King. But how do you want to attack him? Okay, if I burn the throne, which I think is made of paper, I'm going to lose everything, so I should burn his tail. You decided to burn his gross, long, hairy tail. Good plan. Whoosh. The Rat King's tail is on fire. He does not like that one bit. He starts freaking out, waving his tail around like crazy. know all the trash and dirty diapers in the sewer? Those are highly flammable, which means the same as flammable for some reason. Suddenly, the entire sewer catches on fire. You're surrounded by gross sewer flames. Is this really how you die, burning to death with the Rat King in a disgusting sewer? Yes, it is. Damn it. Wait, which... Okay, I'm losing track of what page I'm supposed to go to. Okay, burn the throne instead. You decide to burn the Rat King's throne. It hurts you to burn all that amazing homework, including your wonderful book report, but you remember that it's for a good reason. As soon as the throne catches on fire, the Rat King begins screaming, "No, my throne!" Suddenly, the Rat King begins to shrink. Before long, he is back to the size of a normal rat. He can't even climb out of his huge crown. Ah, he's so cute now. Run back to class and tell Miss Andrews all about the Rat King and everything that happened. Not only does she forgive you for not having your book report, but she declares you are the greatest hero in the school. The end. Okay. This is so inventive, Maxine and Chloe, but next time, please do the book report you were assigned. Alright. Is there anything else here? Anything that might help me at all? Da-da-da. I guess not.
Yes! Take that, Rat King.
I thought maybe there's something would be hidden in there for this treasure map. Alright.
Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude.
Alright then.
Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try.
Maybe it's in the textbook somewhere. Aha. Well, we have found it.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? We made the telescope and amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be, as long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver ride again, bitches!
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Okay.
Okay. Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet.
I swear the bathroom is a little different in the first game. Alright, let's move on.
The entrance to the dark cavern is in there. Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet.
Alright.
There it is. The dark. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
Alrighty. The crate should do the trick. This is not going to go well. Alright, there's nothing in here. What's this? Oh, I can't pick it up, so... I don't think any of that's going to be of help. Is there anything in this room? Da-da-da.
Principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Price. I would like to begin by saying we are thrilled to have Chloe at Blackwell. Rest assured, her scholarship is not in jeopardy at this time. However, it seems she's having trouble transitioning into this new, more challenging environment. I'm emailing to set up a time to talk about the incident that occurred last week. Very concerned about Chloe's behavior and would like to work with you to take steps to correct it as soon as possible. I'm sure you are as dedicated to Chloe's success here as we are. Future needs excellence. Regards, Ray Wells.
Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her.
Okay, this... Oh, it's a response. Chloe was not the only student to act out that day, and if you ask me, Marisa Rogers isn't the victim, she's the bully. Maybe if both sides of the story were heard before placing blame, your school would be a less challenging environment for your students. Focus on your school, I'll focus on my daughter.
Voicemail? I wonder if it's still there.
These types of people are exactly why I didn't want Chloe at Blackwell. We'll figure this out, I promise. I forgot to tell you, Miss Rogers called while we were out yesterday and left a message. It's still on the answering machine, but please be careful when you listen to it. I don't want Chloe to overhear. Need to figure out how to handle this. I know the principal said her scholarship isn't in danger, but I still worry. Okay. Okay, is there anything... That should work.
Just need a few more inches.
I need more? Alright, I can't go in there.
I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back.
But, like, there'd be something downstairs. Hell, maybe there's a frickin' step stool downstairs. Books. Alright. I guess it's the books then. This is not going to go the way you think. She's gonna fall. Okay, then. Oh, God. Should have brought a can of bug spray.
Awesome.
Maybe bringing a flashlight would have been a good idea. Oh. Well, that works.
Man, there is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course, Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through.
Okay. Okay, get the amulet. I got that. old TV.
It took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time.
Damn, it's been a long time since I've seen that as well. Okay, let's move this out of the way.
I think I can squeeze through now.
Like, literally, just crawl over it. It's not hard. Man, it's kind of difficult to see in here. The camera angle feels weird. Okay. What can I move next? Where is the amulet? I lost track of it. Where the fuck did it go? Okay, we came through here, and it was like over this way somewhere.
All that furniture is blocking my way. I bet I can find a way through, though. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult.
Big and burly, Max, you're a kid. There's nothing big or burly about you.
Keep it moving, desk. Crap. Guess you have to go back.
Why did I... No. What? Okay, maybe I just can't do that then.
One step closer.
Right. Now.
This desk's pretty heavy.
Why am I pushing it? Oh, okay, I need to move this out of the way then.
This thing is empty. Yes.
All right.
A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
It's like made out of a Christmas ornament or something. Chloe, I think you're getting into this a little too much.
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting people. And spiders.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
Oh, I'm supposed to...
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
I'm just getting some light. This cavern is even darker than I remember.
Did you conquer your fears?
You could say that.
Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way. No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank.
Wait just a minute. Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Grrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this... Stay on.
Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on.
Thanks, Max.
Time to stick the amulet to the telescope. Then that treasure is ours.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Walk the plank.
Okay. Find the tape. Just tape. Thought it was going to be something more interesting. What's this?
Are you ever going to get your kite down from the roof?
It was unhappy in captivity. I set it free.
You must be a hero to kites everywhere.
Oh, look. Tape. Thought I was gonna have to go inside for that one.
One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
I still felt like it was gonna require some other mechanism to, like, click it into place.
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of our feet one day? We thought we were going to be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah. Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with... something?
Here goes nothing. Okay. This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Okay, I feel like this lens is off, so... Let's put that way. And...
Hmm. so close. I just need to Wait.
There we go.
Got it. Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here? Okay. Take a step right. No, no. The other right.
My other right or your other right?
Your other right.
Sure thing. Wait. What?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
That's actually kind of cool. Didn't it say something somewhere about them, someone wanting it? Maybe they moved it?
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Friendship. Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Dear Chloe, how are you today? I am doing very well. It is Friday, June 27th, 2003. It is summer vacation. We are making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We are making it fire-themed. Wasn't it hilarious to find? These are some things we like. Favorite animal. Arabian horse. Max. Otter. Chloe. Favorite food, lobster roll, Max. Coffee ice cream, Chloe. Coffee ice cream is pretty good. I don't like lobster. I don't like any kind of seafood. Favorite class in school, art or library, Max. Science, Chloe. Best friend, each other, both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies, etc.? That's all for now. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Sincerely, Maxine Caulfield. If they were to answer this, I feel like one of the movies they'd say is Blade Runner.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so cool.
Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here is a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? 1. We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. Duh. 2. We have sleepovers at least once a week. 3. We like extremely salty pretzels. 4. We are on a race to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first. 5. We are going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. 6. We have battled many foes and never failed to save each other. What did you guess? If you guessed all of them, you are right. Your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price.
You were really sweet.
Oh, man. That was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop. This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
I just don't know. I thought they'd be home by now. Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything.
Alright, let's start with this.
This container looks like it could last 100 years.
Probably could.
Holy crap. It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room.
Maybe you should come down and power of flight this dude's face off with me. What the fuck? You really deserve that for robbing a bank? Plans.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
The chopper. World's most comfortable seat. Switches pedals from wheels to blades. Also spins blades. Flaming fingers. Holy shit. What the fuck? Ray of sunshine. Sunlight enters here. Mirror and lenses to strengthen sunlight. Laser beam shoots out here. Yeah, I don't think that would work.
Such a good idea. Most of these are pretty far off.
Predictions for the future by Chloe and Maxine. 1. We still hang out with each other, more than with any other person. 2. Both of us are medium popular. 3. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. I don't think you're even on your first. 4. We do not make decisions without consulting each other. The talking skull of our enemies? What the fuck does that mean? Both of us have a pet. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could have come if she wanted. Don't think they did that. One of us has a little sister or brother. Nope. 8. We are doing well in school.
It actually might be really fun to write letters to. Is writing once a week too?
Oh, these are the same things. Billy the squid.
It's good to see you, old friend.
Keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art.
What we got here?
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
All right, where's...
You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Okay. Guess I can't do anything there.
I guess I should try talking to Chloe again about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything.
Let's try again now.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
What the heck?
Max's first tattoo. Okay.
What tattoo am I getting?
A heart with my initials? Duh.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Pushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once our parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She didn't seem to want to talk about anything serious upstairs.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right? Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. I look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning,
but I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Chloe, remember? We're always together.
Even if you're not.
It's true.
Well, let's find something fun to do.
Oh, shit.
Black flies on the windowsill. We are the moon. Winter stole summer's thrill. And the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope your needs a humble hand, not a fox found in your play.
I didn't realize that was today.
Be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even never. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.
That's fucking sad. Well, that's the first episode. It's a bonus episode, and we'll get into the actual first episode of this game tomorrow. I mean, not tomorrow. In the next episode, I mean. Until then, see ya.